This next story is really a trip. What's done in the dark will come to the light. North Carolina Democratic representative secretly switches to the GOP. North Carolina Democratic Representative Tricia Cotham is her name. She secretly switched to the GOP last week, cementing the Republican supermajority in the House of Representatives and Senate. Cotham won the deep blue Charlotte area seat by nearly 20 percentage points. That was just 5 months ago. It was a crowded Democratic primary. Don't forget that. How long was this planned? Cotham told Your World she entered politics to be a public servant and stateswoman, do greater good for all of the great state of North Carolina, having served previously for a decade and returned to office after time outside politics. However, upon her entrance to the caucus, Cotham felt her party had undergone a sudden negative lurch. Quoting, I noticed some pretty big changes in the Democratic Party right when I got here, and it was very disturbing, she said, adding she prominently features the stars and stripes on her personal vehicle and speaks openly about her faith. I've used Jesus several times when I've led our chamber in house prayer. I was told you could never trust a Dem who wears camo, and just this week was called an amosexual. She called those attacks antithetical to what the U.S. stands for, and cited her past work formally across the aisle with Republicans during her tenure. Without Cotham and two other absent Democrats, Republicans were able to usher the bill into law. With Cotham on their side, Republicans will dominate both state, House, and Senate, as well as hand the party a veto-proof majority against the Democratic governor. Of course, Democratic backlash against Cotham came rushing in as news broke of her party jump, many calling for her resignation. House Democratic leader Robert Reeves says, Representative Tricia Cotham campaigned as a Democrat and supporter of abortion rights, health care, public education, gun safety, and civil rights. The voters of House District 112 elected her to serve as that person and overwhelmingly supported Democratic candidates up and down the ballot. The appropriate action is for her to resign so that her constituents are fairly represented in the North Carolina House of Representatives. Anderson Clayton, the state's Democratic Party chair, and Jane White, Mecklenburg County's Democratic Party chair, reiterated Reeves' call for Cotham to step down, calling her betrayal a deceit of the highest order. Now, Cotham says, you know, it takes a lot. I'm a doer. I'm a risk taker. I do what I think is right, even if I'm the only one doing it. That is who I am and what I believe, she said, adding she's open to dialogue with other affiliated Democratic lawmakers who may want to consider leaving the leftist party. So now she's a recruiter, Yasmin. Question number one I have for you, should she resign?
Well, one thing that I thought was funny that she said was like within the last, 5 months or something, then Thank she you. Realized what the Democratic Party really was. Like, really, really, that's what happened. As far as resigning, I don't know if she should resign, but I feel like this shouldn't be allowed to happen because it's a literal bait and switch, right? The people who voted for you likely voted for you because you were a Democrat, not because you were who you are and they loved you independent of party. You know, these people elected a Democrat and they expected their representative to uphold Democratic ideals. Maybe there could be what do they call, like, a surprise election, an emergency election? Mm-hmm. Why can't I can't think of
special
a special election.
Sure.
Thank you. A surprise election is more exciting.
This is a surprise. Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, but with that said, even if that doesn't happen, right? If they are stuck with this now Republican representative that they did not elect, or, you know, that's upholding values that they do not support, we've seen Manchin and Sinema essentially switch parties without actually doing so, right? They can still be a member of that party and play for the other team. they just got a bad Democrat, and it's really, really unfortunate. I think this does call for like some kind of special election circumstance, though.
I think you're exactly right. And it may, just hear me on this, call for some special investigating. And I don't even mean necessarily official, but I'd love to see some investigative journalism here. Because as we know with, let's take the aforementioned cinema, follow the money, follow special interests, and you'll find out maybe what she believes, because she never really says. She never really telegraphs anything, because I don't think there's anything to telegraph. And so this, you know, on this level, it just smells funny. That and the recruiting. Who got to her? Why are you so daft in not knowing? Is that the statement you put out? You don't know what's going on? And that was your first point that you made, Yasmin, that you don't even know what the Democratic Party is. Okay. You know. If I go to Chick-fil-A, which I don't really go to anymore, okay? But I know there's no burgers there. I do know that.
Yeah, I mean, it kind of speaks to a bigger problem in this country, right? I don't want to get into a whole discussion about the flaws of the two-party system, but this kind of exposes the limitations of having a binary party system. Just strictly speaking as like a numbers game, right? When you only have two parties, if you're not one, then you have to be the other. And for the issues facing Americans today, that's never that simple. And it comes down to representation. You know, you have issues like this one where you have Democrats flipping to Republicans once they get into office. Then you also have redlining and gerrymandering and everything in between. But we have a problem in this country of inequity when it comes to representation in government. And the result is that there's a lot more red in government than there probably should be. There's a lot more red than there are red people in the country. And in this case, the Democratic citizens were actually able to win an election and elect a Democrat to represent them. And this was the quote unquote Democrat that they got.
Yeah, I think you're once again exactly right. And I think that we're going to see more of these sneak attacks, because that's what they really are. We can't win at the ballot box, and we believe party over country and everything that's real. And so we'll just do it this way.